Bloomington has many great places to visit, from the Mall of America to some excellent parks to a number of local businesses and everything in between. And a great way to see them all while getting some exercise outdoors is on two wheels. Let's discover Bloomington by bike.
Before we get started, it's important to remember to always wear a helmet, to use front and rear lights on your bike if riding at night, and to follow the rules of the road to keep you and others safe while exploring the city. To learn more about Minnesota bike laws, go to the link on your screen. It's also important to ride where you feel safe. Depending on the location, that might be a designated bike trail, the road, or the sidewalk. But if you are on a sidewalk, be sure to yield to pedestrians and obey any signs that prohibit bicycles. For today's journey, we're going to discover a roughly 9-mile loop around Bush Lake. The loop is mostly flat and would be a good route for bikers of all experience levels. You could start anywhere along this route, but if you want to bike the entire loop, a great place to start is at Dred Scott Playfields. If you're driving to this starting point, the playfields feature plenty of parking, as well as a bike repair station and a wayfinding sign at the corner of Bloomington Ferry Road and West 110th Street to help you plan your route. From there, head north along Bloomington Ferry Road, which curves west before connecting to a tunnel at Bloomington Ferry Trail. Just before the tunnel, you'll pass Countryside Park on the left and Sunrise Park after the tunnel on the right. Two great resting points. When you reach Vaness Road, there's both a sidewalk and a bikeable shoulder space that takes you north to West Bush Lake Road, where you can continue north along West Bush Lake Trail. If you follow the trail along West Bush Lake Road until you reach Highwood Drive, another on-road bikeable shoulder will take you east. Just before you reach East Bush Lake Road, a trail on the right will take you south and cross underneath East Bush Lake Road before connecting with Richardson Nature Center. The Nature Center is a great place to cool off inside its visitor center or take a walk through the many scenic trails. If you prefer cooling off in water, follow the trail from the Nature Center parking lot about a half a mile south to the crosswalk that brings you to East Bush Lake Beach. Here you can go for a swim or explore the trails around the lake. After visiting Bush Lake, if you feel like heading east, a trail takes you across Highland Lake Park Reserve and exits at West 94th Street and Colorado Avenue South. If you want to close the loop back toward Dred Scott, a number of trails through Highland Lake Park Reserve offer plenty of scenic resting stops as well as recreational activities, including Highland Playground and fishing at Highland Lake. The trail that runs along the west side of the lake will take you south and west until it reaches Bush Lake Road again, just north of 102nd Street. Follow the trail along Bush Lake Road south and cross the road at Maryland Road. And then continue south to 106th Street, where the trail curves right around Bloomington Fire Station 5 and heads west back to Bloomington Ferry Road. To end the day, follow Bloomington Ferry Road south to the corner of Old Shakopee Road and enjoy a well-deserved coffee at Westside Perk or a treat at Scoop's Ice Cream. Then cross Old Shakopee Road and you're back where you started at Dred Scott Playfields.
We've only covered a small portion of what you can see around the city on two wheels. For a full bike map, visit the city's website and tune in next time as we continue to discover Bloomington by bike.